Good morning. It's time for the Morning Mindset. I hope you are having a great day. I went on a walk this morning in the wee hours of the morning. It was still almost dark, kind of starting to get light, and I took my dog with me. And man, was I encouraged just watching my dog. It may sound funny, but I saw this Australian Shepherd. It's my daughter's dog, actually, when she was 18 or so. She saved up money and bought this dog, and she's done a good job of training him. And just watching him, he was kind of dragging as the day began, as the walk started. I mean, he always loves walks, but he wasn't his normal self. And then I noticed suddenly there's this change in him. He was running about excitedly ahead of me on the road, and he was all into it. And I noticed he had a stick in his mouth. Just the simplest little thing that changed his whole demeanor. He had a big, thick stick that was about, a foot long, just the perfect size for him. And he's running along with the thing just as happy as he could be. Now, I don't know if it's true that dogs really can be happy if they have emotion like we think of emotion. But the change in his demeanor from such a small thing was quite encouraging to me, because it enabled me to kind of open my eyes and start looking around me and recognize the mountains, the sky, the brisk cold wind that was blowing, all the sensations that God has provided that actually are blessings, just like that stick was a blessing to the dog. Now, he doesn't have the capacity to understand it as a blessing, but he definitely enjoys the experience, it seems. And so I want to encourage you this morning to take a little bit of time to look around you and see what are the things around you that God has placed there that are a blessing to you. Now, I recognize many people who are listening to the sound of my voice right now could be experiencing some very difficult things. I get that. I've been there. Life is a hard thing sometimes. But I also understand that the blessings are there even in the midst of the difficulties. I'm always shaken when I remember this story that Corrie Ten Boom tells. If you don't know who Corrie Ten Boom was, she was a wonderful Christian sister who lived during the time of the Holocaust, and she and her sister were actually taken into a concentration camp. And her writings about her relationship with God and the experiences that she had in that concentration camp are very convicting on many levels. And one of the things that I remember her talking about was the way that she and her sister Betsy learned to thank God for the lice that existed in their barracks in the concentration camp. And why would you thank God for lice? They were in a horrible situation, and lice only seemed to make it worse in a lot of ways. Why would you thank God for the lice? Well, it was because the lice were so thick that it caused the guards to stay out of their barracks. And so they didn't have guards coming in who might molest them or abuse them. The barracks felt like a reprieve. It felt like a safe haven in a way, even though it was infested with lice. And she and her sister, because of their faith in Christ, were able to orient their minds toward understanding that these lice were actually a blessing from God. I wonder what's going on in your life that you could look at it and most of the time perhaps see it as a problem or as a curse, but in fact, it is a blessing. And I want to encourage you finally with a scripture. We've been in Romans chapter 8. Romans chapter 8 says, "Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword?" Now, surely those are not all the things that could threaten our security in God's love. But they're Paul's way of saying nothing can separate you. And we're going to dig into this more in the next few days. I hope you'll stick around and make sure you listen to these Morning Mindset editions of the Live, Build, Change podcast. I am praying for you today to live out your faith in a vibrant way that brings you thankfulness. God bless. I'll talk to you tomorrow.